If you watched my first theory, you're possibly backtracking on other theories you or someone else within the I Got 7 fandom have had. Before we address my second theory, allow me to muddle things up. Most won't believe that the events within the trailer for Flight Log Turbulence, what with the guys floating like they were in the Departure one and the flashbacks, is second in sequential order. But nothing solidifies this as a fact. What about the flipped over car, you ask? Because we saw Departure first in the trilogy, we assume this is the same van. However, it's completely charred, and any physical evidence of it being the van or a van at all is contextual. It could be a completely different vehicle. There also could be other vehicles involved, as at the 2:05 mark in the Turbulence trailer shows what appears to be the trailer of another vehicle in the upper right-hand corner. Well, duh, that could be the underbody of the car, you're thinking. Do an image search of a car's underbody and you'll see that none are slated like that. Not saying he won't see images of them slatted, but not that closely together. The most likely thing is it's the trailer attached to the truck we see in Departure while they're playing basketball, but it doesn't explain why it's there in the Turbulence trailer. Also, some believe that the boys might have veered into water, but none is visible from their travels during the Departure trailer, and there's no evidence of water submersion in the Turbulence trailer. Even in the Harakiri teaser video 1, they're on dry land. This is a chance for y'all to challenge me. Bam Bam's face. Yeah, we saw the drawing happen in Departure, but again, what confirms that this was the first moment the drawing happened? And finally, Jackson's camera. Jackson's camera, completely unscathed in all that wreckage, playing the images from Departure. This is just a reflection of Jin Young's memories. I'd like to say that he's not even in the video replay, but that would be completely wrong, as you can see him with Mark and others at the Turbulence trailer 2:18 point. But I'm sticking with what it is, being a memory. Which leads us into this theory. JJ Project is dead. Long live GOT7. Continuing on with the Turbulence trailer, we see six of the guys playing on a plane, JB included. We never hear JB say a word to anyone despite all the noise. And we never see him engaging more actively than necessary, as if he's there to oversee the group. We first see him appear at the 11-second mark, overlooking all of the group. At the 16:17 mark, we see him move aside to let Jackson and Bam Bam pass him. Right? Or maybe he's stepping aside to give GOT7 room. He's still watching with a smile at the 18-second mark and quietly beating Mark with a pillow in a few frames later. At the 42-second mark to be exact, we catch him in the upper left-hand corner, hitting no one as the rest of the group huddles together. JB and Jin Young are the only ones alone. Rewind to Departure, and he is leading the group by driving them, with Jin Young intermixed with everyone physically, but not necessarily mentally. JB says very little in this trailer as well. In fact, his only line is speaking to himself under his breath about how fun things are. Did you realize that our M leader is separate from the majority of the group in each part of this trilogy, from being the only person in the driver's seat, to floating above a bed on his own, or being in a forest that lives and dies in his presence, or even riding shotgun in a car that's driving itself, your faves could never. And then drowning? No one else has experienced implied death by water except Jin Young. Symbolism for JJ Project being awash in favor of nourishing GOT7? I mean, GOT7's hand sign is a 7, but all the same, it's the JJ Project sign upside down. And during the long-awaited GOT2Day segment of JB and Jin Young less than a year ago, they stated that the era of JJ Project is a wrap. It's all speculative, of course, but the next time we see JB in a teaser, the arrival one, he's frolicking amongst his brothers, fully invested in where they are and who they are becoming. And Jin Young is eager to join them. We'll look at the next theory tomorrow.